going in. Can't bring him over without the cop jaws, eh? Jesus Christ, come on the kingdom.
Supporting the struggle for the maintenance of the jobs, the direct employment of the people here, their paying conditions, and against a company that has massive profits, and their greed obviously knows no bounds, and they're prepared to sacrifice the people who've made this company the success it is in this island, and it's not acceptable. We're here to support these workers. The struggle will be won.
We're up here because the Labour Court will protest our company, because the Labour Court would accept the recommendation. The company would accept the recommendation from the Labour Court. So we're here to protest with our company because of that situation, which is very unusual in the present day situation, anyone not recognising the Labour Court.
We're from the Danish Social Democratic Party in Denmark, the youth organisation is called DSU, and we're here today to join you in the demonstration. And this is all my friends from Denmark. Say hi to...
Wednesday's march was really to highlight to the people of Dublin the frustrations of the workers of Coca Cola. And in doing so, we seem to have attracted an awful lot of previous Coca Cola employees who came out of retirement, so to speak. And we'd like to take this opportunity to thank them for doing so. Also, the committees in Ballyfermot. The NTL workers which came along, and also the members of all the different unions involved which came and helped us on our quest.
My name's Celine. I'm on the workforce with Coca-Cola. I've been 34 years in the workforce, 12 of which I've spent working for Coca-Cola. In that period of time, I have never been on strike in my life. I came out in solidarity with the 130 workers who have been sacked, and I will remain out on strike with them. The fact that the Labour Court agreement has come down in their favour proves to me that this fight is worthwhile and right.
We had a demonstration to show to the people who supported Coca-Cola all of these years in Dublin what these new management team were at doing. And is that to bring us out onto the streets? You know, I walked out on the streets to Liverton, but now I'm out on the streets, right, defending me job. The farmers have to go out and drive tractors and block up the cities to show them that they're fighting for a living. And we have to do the same.
Don't think that you can come in and pull the wool over our eyes by you dictating, telling us what you're going to do. Because you're not going to win. We're Irish and we fight to the bitter end.